utilitarian application of power which attempts to comprehend spectacle and retain the projection of the bodies of the people in prison, white supremacy produces institutionalized conceptions hierarchized of difference or the enforcement of coercion and violence structured genocidally, possibly socially, culturally, or biologically. The prison is a technology of carceral violence that draws from white supremacy of the substructure of the years, but a national formation, civil society, and globality. And the laws imperative desire, resistance, failure to critique legal institutions perpetuates conformity, oppressive minds of the institutions that are deeply embedded in cultural rulings. 87. Racism resembles offense against humanity, so deeply embedded in cultures to prove perfect, seemingly resistant to be recognized as oppression. The laws from subcategory of social motives and police, which is born when society decided that these laws become sterile and formal as a result, that was conformed to the system, which even techno-legalism obfuscates and undermines the justice of the real, in which human beings are hated to franchise culture, needing ideas to redefine the laws, people's cultural love, keeps society humane. Blacks are outlawed from hopeful expectations, freedom, and soul. The human being brings about legacies for us, probably invisibly reinforcing structure of language, thought, and law. There's responsibility for never forgetting one another's history, making real psychic, holy racial lives on, shaping the real relations, and discrimination, repel, hillside, ostracize, alienate a fundamental part of our dignity, depend on the uncontrollable external observers who constitute a society, socialization, option, clinic, care, responsibility, damage, developer, positive within a system of formalized, traditional thought, produces social structure centered around fear and hate, provides a tumultuous outlet for feelings elsewhere around its rise. Next are the harms. Massive imprisonment is modern fascism, perfected by technology, embracing class warfare, rages, every facet of society, economic, political domination, feels constructive, incorporable, underlies violent propensity, must be controlled and exterminated. Still in 2013. Political repression is reached monstrous proportion, black and brown people, victims of most basic and calculated class, national and racial oppression, fear of the broad masses of overwhelming majority, poor, full of prisons are subject to intelligence, surveillance, since the fascist genocidal program of white Americans, medical safety, and chains and corpses of prisons are war, and the black and the arms, and the courts, and the incarceration, the experience of the hostile, concentrated, care of the class warfare, colonized, convergence between the racialized politics, the law, and the order of the poverty, created to industrialized, produce the largest prison system in the world, increasing brutality of the courts, prisons, police, courts, prisons, and emerging economic crisis of reflective, systematic, and disintegration, and ascendancy, the prison industrial complex arises from neoliberal construction of social state, criminalization of poverty, lynchment, and controlling racialized underclass of wage slavery, under its functioning economy designed to benefit the few, why not 08? One must grasp and forth from contradicting neoliberal decay of the public sector, the rise of the people say that manifests the criminalization of poverty is indispensable to the wage labor, wage labor is an obligation at the bottom, thus institutionalized imprisonment method, aiming at the control of the deep population, nowadays cultural apparatus, as well as the knowledge control perspective, reproduction superfluous. Poor blacks near in the form of industrial cities, prison is a brigade, central place, and monopoly of instruments for government poverty, next insolvency. I advocate plea bargaining to be abolished in the U.S. criminal justice system. Plea bargaining system supports incentivized over criminalization out in 2015. Current state legislation amend laws, add more charges, different penalties, and prosecution more power, plea bargaining is extraordinary, prosecutorial powers embedded in criminal codes, coercive taxes, a ban, offices of regularly evaluated prosecutors based on conviction, which goes hand in hand with courts, crafted prosecutors, the other must file charges, and get conviction to guilty, please, action contribute to prosecutorial culture, supports increased violence, and the most important determining factor to dramatically increase incarceration rates, enforcing every case to go to trial, creates this cascade of decriminalizing reform that undermines the prison, social complex, and free resources to address the social generations of that crime. Is not advocate for the ban, but describes what happened if the bar is no longer utilized higher 2016. Mass assertion of due process could overwhelm the prosecutorial regime, drugs, and mass incarceration to crisis and force action short-term prosecutors could desist from prosecuting hundreds of thousands were annually charged non-violent subjects across the state for federal jurisdictions of some 150,000 people, 50% of those convicted plead guilty non-violent federal prosecutors put in pressure for requirements of justice, purposes of the prison prosecutor desist from non-violent litigation must combine with the systemic shifts and reduction police and priority practices by choosing an organization program and desist of growth perceived legitimacy of criminal policies and potentiality before the legislative reform the direction of decriminalization of prison, industrial complex, to devour social wealth needed to adjust the very problems that have been led to spiraling numbers of prisoners because public financing of mass incarceration over $125 billion in public wealth freedom due to investment, social reparative, generative enterprise like education, childcare, mental and physical health care, drug treatment, public housing, job training, food assistance, etc. And abolishing the regular living practices of perpetuating criminalization and shielded from scrutiny to Durban 2010. If there are no plea bargaining, non-legal theory, the number of that should no longer be told to prosecute and charge and bars and significant cost of prosecuting individual be real consideration determining bring a prosecution over the section would be used to create salaries between differential that force individuals to falsely confess plea bargaining over criminalization perpetuate each other, plea bargaining shields over criminalization for scrutiny over criminalization nation creates concepts that make plea bargaining so pervasive. Next are the impacts. Prisons are dehumanizing and brutal violence and sexual slaughter endemic with Lloyd 2015. Prisons are placing tense brutality, violence, and dehumanization with prisoner without basic prisoner movement is tightly controlled, shackled bodies forced to basic services, humane interact only a number of terms is reduced to a number of deprived individual authority, goals, discomfort, and loneliness, and individual prison personal value begins to grow them. Must think of these look at these practices because ideology of the criminal regulation renders much of the criminal process to advise consequences invisible to many of us removing the violent results from a review that ideology persuades us of necessity and harm system incarceration prison the production of violence of prisoners seated on each other improve their position of through assault, sexual abuse, and rape orders produced with explicitly sanctioned regime instruction control to prisoners rape and brain that 30% of prison inmates have been sexually assaulted in prison. Many suffer repeat assault, sexual abuse in 2008, 216,000 victims, and mass incarceration affects vicious cycles of political disempowerment and alienation to thwart social change and maintain structural racism. Roberts report. Mass imprisonment disenfranchised communities profound prisons destroy social and economic resources and necessary for communities to have the same political process to organize institutions and contest unjust policies is creating norms that question the effectiveness of efforts to produce change. Mass imprisonment impairs community structures of channel resistance as the communities engage from political society signifies as a criminal depressed legislatures implemented and preceding collateral consequences of criminal convictions and consequences culminating social exclusion offenders, Travis 2002. Criminal suspension be denied, housing, welfare, drugs are required, driving, child support, parentalized education, social and safety has been severely damaged once that society never pays punishment, become instruments of social exclusion. They create a permanent delineation between the social status and victim offenders institute between us and them. The denunciation of criminals was politically rewarded.
I caught it at politically rewarding in the Travis card.
Okay. Can I get an actor for the resolution?
What do you mean, like an actor?
Like, who passes the plan?
I would say that, like, the legislature, so, like, Congress would pass the plan that...
So, Congress.
Like, yeah, so, like, within the criminal justice system, it would say, like, tell the criminal justice system.
Let's talk about your Heiner card. So, you say that he doesn't advocate for a ban. What does he advocate for instead?
So he doesn't, like, advocate for anything in particular. However, this is just, like, something that he thinks theoretically would lead to, like, creating solvency.
Why in particular is abolishing plea bargaining the mechanism to which we should craft a system? Like, where is a warrant that says that plea bargaining is the one thing that's keeping it alive?
So I don't know about, like, the one thing, but the Durbin 2010 card does a really good job of talking about how plea bargaining shields overcriminalization because there's this assembly line effect in which prosecutors can get...
Is plea bargaining the only thing that's sustaining the prison industrial complex?
What do you mean the only thing?
Like, is plea bargaining the one barrier we have to deconstructing the mindset of the criminal justice system?
I would argue yes.
Why?
Because as I said, the reason why the criminal justice system is able to function as it is and incarcerate so many individuals is because it can move through these cases so quickly.
Okay.
If we were to break down their ability to go through all those cases.
Let's talk about your Durbin card talking about how it shields it from scrutiny. Card about shielding from scrutiny, just checking, you can't use this to cross, like, shady cross-ups on, like, evidence that I read saying that, like, it shouldn't be validated or something like that. Just check.
I don't know what you're...
Oh, okay. Just checking to make sure there's no shady cross-ups with it.
I don't know what you mean by shady.
Okay,
Am I going to cross-apply the card? Yes.
Okay, and what... All right, let's talk about...
I don't know what... It depends on the...
Okay, all right, we got it. Okay. Let's talk on the role of the ballot.
Sure.
You say that we need... Like, it needs... We can't conform to the system. Is there any pre-fiat offense you get off of this, or...?
I would say that, like, critiquing the system is a prerequisite to any...
I'm asking, is there pre-fiat offense? Like, do you get offense from critiquing the system, or do you get offense from solvency?
I will only garner offense from critiquing the system if you read a keg.
Wait, so does solvency matter?
Yes.
Okay, finally, on where's the internal link between abolishing plea bargaining and prisons going away? Like, you just seem to jump from it undermines the prison industrial complex to prisons are bad.
Sure. So I'm not, like, the end goal of the AC isn't to, like, destroy, like, prisons, but it nearly means that we should, like, shrink the criminal justice system and, like, greatly decrease mass incarceration.
When you say shrink, how big is the shrink?
I don't have, like, a number.
Oh, is it significant?
Yes.
All right, sure. I'll let Papa.
You said what?
I said I'll let Papa.
Okay.
Signed up. three off that case. Case starting on framing, then solvency, and then also signpost. Yeah.
You said three off?
Three off, yeah.
Okay, cool.
Like, the actors are deplete where every single case gets a trial. And not only the actors of black people in the situation where they have to depend on white juries to acquit them. This is about because black juries are not selected in pure exclusive. Alabama, Louisiana, Houston, North Carolina, which means there's no nullification after bride. Even if black jurors are selected to be on the panel, the CJs are systematically excluded. Black jurors are an astonishing rate, lived to Act 15. Many prosecutors and independent lawyers that didn't reimburse judges allow them to use entities, right? To use safe on advice and receptive juries. Vow to repair to the 48% black and 83% of the defendants were black. But the jury hit the list of four blacks on the potential juries in the studies. Prosecutors were strikes against 46% of black potential jurors who were reading against 50% of the other, 93% in trials, prosecutors struck at a higher percentage of pardons of black and felony countries. In Alabama, used brain 30 strikes to remove 82% of eligible black jurors from a trial in which the death penalty was imposed. And white people don't even deliberate in courtrooms so they have to make a life or death decision. Studies prove Elderman 15. Experiments show that all white majorities want less time to deliberate, make more factual mistakes, and more likely to convict a minority than if you might racially diverse or race. And white folk will always nullify night white folk. We're not making an analytical claim. White people use nullification to nullify Klan members. Our claim is rooted in history, wrestler. And this is Texas, state prosecuted 500 whites for murdering blacks in 18 to 55. In each trial, all the white juries appointed reasonable defendants. Even often, it's a white offender, bringing 9 out of 10 cases later, the government who committed a crime, prosecuted to oversight of the grand jury, the Ku Klux several audience members, the grand perjury jurors, and one of their all hands, and his but to be one of the number who may be on trial, impact the efforts of black people. Go to trial instead of taking police. The question is not crashing the system, but rather why do innocent black folks get to use have to, do not get to use the ability of plea bargains? This is a survival tactic to avoid racist trial. It's better to get years of life than every years of life if you lose, and all of our internal links so that they're more likely to lose because of racial jury. So the plea bargaining should be used as a survival tactic. That app is in a double bind. Either A, they get all the same quality of black people will be good, but if we all over internal links so that won't happen, they use black people under racist trials as a means of collapsing the system, which is inherently anti black, or B, they abolish plea bargaining. That's fantastic. Because black people need the ability to survive, they're forced to go to trial and get the light of law in prison. Next office, crack. The antithought is the protection of belief in the presence of resolution, and doubt requires a controversial of release through experimental methodology and the skepticism of absolute truth. Taha. Truth is opinion always a community of groups, but the fact of being worthy of truth is based on empirical science that you believe, because the purpose of hearing the group of rights being don't get in weakness, outward liars, superability, which imagines the man of early experience, commences the reputation of doubt, assessed the world, reason of that struggle, that they believe the struggle is in at least the ability to break falls with the sole object of being worthy, so that it believes consistent on the experimental that is, doesn't lie, there's a problem that is rooted in reality, that is not something we don't just approach knowledge of, it because in reality, it's a perfect complete sense, it's something that is constructed by indefinitely. Your struggle is a problem, and the inquiry is continuous. This view is based on a view to power system, which insists on the nobility that we finally reviewed is verified or beyond question. Hence, I can begin investigation as an overall thing. The provision which leads to progress as a standard is consistent with pragmatic decision making procedure. Impact of it. A, this is not usual. The question of following certain procedures while maximizing end. And do you pragmatism on an ethical area, but in the area of truth, proposed as a method for deciding what constitutes a legitimate justification? This pragmatic theory controls all modes of decision making. Absolutely certain certainty about the unjustness of plea bargaining destroys value for research that serves a pragmatic purpose of effort and ignores particular situations. Leave our recently to ask often tomorrow's 94. Apart from the reality and duty case from a limited resource available to something and benefit to be evolved, I believe Bernie has a better sort of the community and market taking every case into often their prime victims is not one of these subject to the rigorous trial. Some cases look at the lead, a little less for maybe mercy on only for the keys, but the accused is not case of judge and lawyer, you know, the compelling evidence that the older the judge usually will have decided that is such evidence that's not going to be liable in this case, the lead will deserve a conviction in which the trial may result in acquittal or virtue of your plea bargaining or not go to the beliefs that have someone go to the essence of justice. Next up. The United States Congress should legalize marijuana, short incentives for nonviolent offensive, downgrade the majority of nonviolent offensive, for felonies and misdemeanors, limited criminal justice spending, inflation and justice levels, suspended in 1980, and used to free funds to invest in socially reparative and generative enterprises. That's a reform that our advocates for. It solves the entirety of the case. Heiner 16. Legislative briefers in the and direction of the legislation of drugs, the measures legalized, the Police Rights Reform Act, the short incentive that those objectives of life in prison time to those to non-serious, nonviolent offensive, downgrade nonviolent offensive, for felonies and misdemeanors. Heiner continued to be looked at by Republican right to mass incarceration, because right returning criminals are suspending the inflation and adjusted levels of 1980, you know, the over 125 billion health through the public goal of UW every year, and very investment in education, child, mental, physical, health care, drug team, to show public housing, job training, to redesign personal recreation, for enterprise, because we're actually more people to be our American social system currently employed in the institution that are out of the prison. And now, starting on going on to case, so starting on framing, pragmatist methodology is preferable to have the method for realizing the universal claim to criticize, ignore the particulars of oppression, whereas pragmatism and context specific, and the zoom through framing, PAPA 16. Instead of universal principles, we also mean with an endocrine free problem of justice, where pragmatism references the injustice and public remiss of a particular realities to relevant and the universal philosophies and authoring in the conduct of history. These are usually nothing but theoretical interaction and the practice of meaningful dealing with the structural historical system with totality of being able to take in a real problem of the potential ceremony of a real concrete experience of the pressure to be the starting point and let us try knowledge of these whole interpretations of a magnetic law, which will come later in for these signs, or the theoretical abstraction that every preferable when I do enter preferable theory because it exists that everyone has their own ability to engage in experimentation, which always gives people agency within their impressive structures, means that it always precludes the app because there's a better mechanism to ensure that every single person is engaged within the system. So next, starting on solvency, plea bargaining is usually trying to prosecutors and judges will serve as a claim. You don't practice the system, economy 17. And American prosecutors are blocking freedom, but owners are blaming the 17 to it on the veil. We are winning the lesson, even then they happen informally. Judging the implicit deals with the defendants, all has a family where you're 1925, during the college of 2 years, and trial by temples, prosecutors are to try to keep your parts with new judges encouragement. Other changes offset abolition, near Bury and Frasca 11. Evidence of abolition change, believe where you produce offsetting changes, inclusion of appeal and indefinitely after affordability and plea bargaining, especially with others, until you think everybody's increased, and it's about justice, prosecutors, their ability to control the disposition decrease. When the one coast guard eliminated plea bargaining, there was no increase in sentence severity. The overall policies are heavy, there's a reason to the negotiation, and it seems that the importance of CP is always going to solve some comparatively better. And the second is talking about that you don't access any of the impacts of your case, don't let them use any possible application of the frame you're talking about. They critique the system, and that's good. You should force them to hold them accountable for all the consequences of the affirmative. Next on to the incarceration and impacts. So they might reduce their conviction, but increase the sentence on laying on worse, which is on the worse on average of value of 17. If believers are allowed, these defendants are convicted, they're probably higher for their time. I'm able to go back to probably the evaluation of the means of an offer. The expected defense is increased considerably without rewarding the upper master 193% and the other defense would be where footed the average defendant would be considerably worse off. It means that you can't collapse the prisoning system because they will just put people in there for longer, which means there's absolutely no way they could collapse, which means that it will just be net worse for all these people that are stuck within the prison. It's a court clause. So I'll impact her in crashing the courts of delayed kills goes for instance and Gorilla 14. Economic performance right influenced by the judicial system, and the numerical hazards agree that quality right remaining it goes to economic wounds. The legal system may influence the choice of the economic factors determining decision related to investment training and decline causes war. Thomas said 15. Enterprise is risen to cause of conflict. Leaders that usually fear and anticipate their national pride, enabling the external giants appeal and a formal credit sentiment is commonly used for them to be deterred by nuclear bombs. As if shift could happen, it will not be cut the card there. And we're in structural violence, Horgan 12. There seems to be no condition that an inability aside to aid builders and more or less than it wanting, scarcely is designed for blood of a structure. Wars on a copy of capitalism, fears, and gender and the aid of pressure, any single cause, although these inability wars outcomes, rather wars fueled and sustained by other injustices. That's good. So cut the last card and then.
So the last card you read was the Tonneson card?
Oh, no, the last card on the dock is the PHAW card.
PFAW?
Yeah.
Okay, so that's the last card you read.
Yeah.
But you just cut it.
Oh, no. I said cut that card, but I cut. Do you just want me to send that to the dock?
Can you speak while you cut it?
Oh, yeah, totally.
Yeah? Okay, so then we'll just process now. Okay, everyone. Okay, so let's start on the pragmatics arguments you make on case. You say, so after the Pappas card, you said some analytic about how you give everyone agency. Can you explain
sure.
that?
Sure, so pragmatism is a theory that, at first, it's a procedural theory, so it says that everyone engages in their own process of experimentation and knowledge
sure.
of the world. And so it's saying that theory gives individuals agency because it means that they could always shape their outcomes around them, so it's a preferable theory.
But how do, governments and, big groups of people then make these things? If it's, a very, individual...
I'm not saying... I'm just saying it's a preferable reason because it gives people agency.
I know, so you give people agency. My question...
Are you making government specific claims? We're saying that the government should also be contextualizing this to the people, because for example, there are different policy actions that can help different people at different.
So we should look at the particular. So we should just look at particular scenarios, and then based on those particular scenarios, evaluate whether or not something should be used or not.
I suppose so. Yeah.
Okay. Sounds good. What's the status of the counterplan?
Condo.
Okay. And then let's go on to the jury's racist argument.
Mm-hmm.
Does the counterclaim solve for this?
Yeah.
How?
Because we're saying that not the counterclaim. Well, it's more the claim that currently, if you abolish plea bargaining, that means that you force them to go to trial.
Mm-hmm.
We're saying that the counterclaim's net better because as long as you don't force the people to go, that means that they can still use plea bargaining as a survival tactic. Because regardless
sure.
of whether
but
or not you abolish.
How does the counterclaim solve for, we make the claim that the system itself.
Oh, because, regardless of whether, because, if you abolish the system, it's people are still going to be racist, right? So you're going to, you force people in Alabama, you're going to force black people in Alabama to go stand in front of an all-white jury and force them, and, make them get it.
Yeah, so how does the counterclaim solve for that?
We're saying that it allows them to take plea deals.
Okay,
and
not everyone's gonna take a plea deal. So what about the people who don't take plea deals?
They take plea deals. you want me to read evidence saying that they
Okay, what about people, so you're telling me every black person in Alabama takes a plea deal?
No, it's
saying
it should be used as a survival tactic, i.e. they want to use it to survive, they should be able to use it. It's a choice that they can make, and it's something that's obviously good for them, right? Like, they don't, in front of Alabama, you're risking having a life in prison because of an all-white jury. So they should have the decision on whether or not they want to subject themselves to that, right?
Still not answering my question. Are you going to answer
Do you want to answer the question?
Yeah, I would like you to answer the question.
Repeat the
question.
Saying
in the world of the counterplan, do some people still refuse plea bargains?
Sure, yeah, but we're saying it should be used as a survival tactic.
Okay.
So we're not saying we solve for it or something like that. We're just saying that it's a preferable method that they should use, right?
Sure.
Here, let me sign out the doc.
Yeah, I'll start prepping you.
Are you still hooked up to the Wi-Fi? Because I know the Wi-Fi disconnects.
Yeah, it sometimes connects and sets the whole thing. Thank you.
job without breaking down and critiquing this ideology of the criminal justice system will never be just. Mass incarceration has three impacts: dehumanization, political disempowerment, and poverty. The assault in one, three ways. First, system overload, the prosecutorial assistance. Two, prosecutorial and public pressure prompts legislatures to decriminalize. And three, policing practices reform in response to prosecutorial assistance. Now let's go on to the privacy in your hands. You can group at them. One, I am particularly looking at this racist and neoliberal state that is using the prison industrial complex to sustain like its racist structures. Things that we need to break it down. I am being practiced because I do look at these particular measures. And second, she said that we need to give everyone agency, and that's why privatism is good, but that's not going to be good for governmental agencies. We just have our own individual experiments. We have to have broad ideas together, which we can all stand behind, not like particular, not just like particular experiences we have. So now we can go into particular answers. First, I'm going to give economists evidence that there's going to be circumvention. There's going to be two responses. Prosecutors are not going to risk their jobs and participate in this illegal behavior just to have a plea bargain. This doesn't make any sense. And second, we showed you through the higher court that there's going to be desistance. Instead of participating in illegal behavior, prosecutors are going to demand that the legislature changes the way that the system works so their jobs are easier. Then onto the newer question, she talks about this is just an increased rate of dismissal, but this is just a one small county. We say that there's 97% of plea bargaining is dealt with a plea bargain. This is going to be a major increase, which means that you can't dismiss all these cases. It's literally impossible. There's still going to be court clock. Then on to Silver, she says that this increases the length of, or he says that this increases the length of the time that you spend in jail. But turns, this is actually good because it proves our case that instead of prosecutors going for like misdemeanors, they're going to go for like big like crimes like rape and murder, which means obviously you're going to increase the time you spend in jail because those are offenses that you should be spending time in jail for, not like for possessing possessing like coke. Now you can prove like all the turns about like economic downturn. This is just going to be a reason why the app's actually able to solve. Because I say that legislature is going to be demanded by the public to have reform. Public knows it's going to lead to economic downturn, so they're going to demand that the government does something before anything gets worse because they don't want it to collapse. This just proves that the app solvency works. Now we can go into the reform counterplay. While he guesses the reform will happen, he does not do the keys in that higher avenue. He's forcing the government to see just a question to change his practice after going for a few or criminals, at least to three salty deficits. First, the assembly line process of justice will just continue the world to see because plea bargains will still exist. The system is racist. We need to streak it through its collapse. Second, time frame after the app. Prosecutors will have to stop prosecuting as many people tomorrow, but under the net, we still have to have drawn out reform. And three, drug-related crimes are not the main cause of mass incarceration. Out in 2015, once lawyer examining the data surrounding incarceration rates on the state level, federal incarceration accounts for 12% of total incarceration population in the United States. Drug offenses are not the main reason that incarceration rates in Florida account for only 17% of the incarcerated. And that's why you should first purge your math. Both through the app and counterpoint. Second, perm through the app and then the counterpoint allows the system to grapple with this problem, then address them in the way that Heiner suggests. Now it's the pragmatism NC. One, pragmatism is issue. Two, the reason why we value the counterpoint is to help us achieve good impact. Just as an individual has a better impact, the collective bargaining must be helpful in a few years' ability to be used by prosecutors, of course, minors into better bad deals, plus increase massive restriction, very possible in impact. As a larger rate, second, turn under pragmatism, we get rid of the larger because plea bargaining is helpful in ending racism, which is a prerequisite for achieving a just society by restoring black communities and truth, that they will be unable to build a coalition, meaning of plea bargaining can counteract remaining duty deconstructing racism, three term, and limiting plea bargaining possible, and that allows us to reform the teachers and institute broadly before we allocate $125 billion towards social and health and educational system. That's higher than also, particularly, the DeMars card is horrible. She says that the reason why she should went under the NC because we're not 100% certain that plea bargaining can never be used for good things, but then that would mean we have that we could pass absolutely no policy because we never have 100% probability that in every single scenario the policy is going to work in a good way. This is bad to freeze this policy after we never reform or do anything. We'd just be stuck in the status quo because we're scared that there might be some non-zero impact of like something bad. Now into the jury decide. One, now you need prosecutors and judges are racist. She doesn't solve for this. Second, turn hundreds of thousands of individuals into the system because prosecutorial assistance. Three, a turn question system leads to reform and decriminalize these offenses. Four, turn this is bad to survive strategy because of horrible consequences of plea bargaining, like sexual assault and losing your right to vote. And five, behind the skeptical that everyone is racist rhetoric. He's citing things from like the KKK. Yes, maybe people in Alabama aren't always right, but that increase the number of black jurors and people, white people who like are not racist. Means it's no impact.
said prosecutors will demand the legislative to do something, so are, is the legislative branch still doing the plan, or are you fiating prosecutors do it, or what?
Oh no, so the legislature is the one who says,
okay, legislative passes.
And then prosecutors are gonna be like, hey, we can't get through all these
cases.
Do
you fiat that, or is that a result?
We say, like, the Heiner card, we don't fiat that. We fiat that there's, like, we eliminate plea bargaining, and then these are, like, the impacts that come from that.
The order is gonna be, the Prag NC, the CP, and the jurors decide, not in case. Not going for the privacy. So first, I'll repeat around the CP solves all of their impacts. It should be a question of whether or not plea bargaining is crucial in abolishing the system. We'd argue that instead it's a survival strategy that the system will people will be racist regardless of whether or not you abolish the criminal justice system, but it's a question of whether or not you should subject black people to it. So next, starting on the, so next, for another CP, so extend the CP, you should legalize marijuana short sentences for nonviolent offenders, downgrade the majority of the nonviolent offenses from felonies to misdemeanors, and limit criminal exponential, which means it. We have wish within next, all of the arguments you say, first for response to the assembly line, but first, it's salty the assembly line. Making because it says that we're going to put less people in the system, which means that you can't even have that assembly line thought process in the second place. And second, assembly line, second, you've solved all the impacts. There's not a single, all of these, solved the impacts. There's not a single one. And so why assembly line process is the sole thing that's leading to the result of all of it. It says that the CP will resolve for all of that by making sure that there are far less cases in order to go after, which means that you can't even have that mindset within the first place. And it also solves by having the, as long as you allow for freeing funds, that means you can also allow for a wide scale restructuring of the criminal justice system, which means it solves the entirety of the case. Next, you say that with a time frame, but no, we say that fiat resolves that. We say fiat resolves it as soon as you feel the possession happens. That means that you have to downgrade all the sentences. We think that immediately comes to a halt, and next, you say that it's a drug on the main cause. But so that's only one of the points of the CP. It's all the higher also references that we should downgrade most of the nonviolent offenses and misdemeanors. That's not solely drugs, and you say that it's a perm, but there's absolutely no impediment to the perm. You've never isolated a single warrant. To not talking about why plea bargaining this uniquely key. That should be the biggest question. You have to evaluating the debate orders are to your plea bargaining is uniquely key. Although it just says that it allows it for the system to rethink itself, but it's exactly the CP. The CP is making sure the system reworks itself. So next, go on to the jurors to set. When you abolish plea bargaining, you force people, black people, to go to trial. What happens? They extend Lit Tech 15, is saying that it allows the CGS excludes black jurors and allows them to strike them, which means that they get sent to a disproportionately white jury. Instead, Element 15, saying that white people don't need to deliberate, which takes out all their nebulous racism claims to know psychological studies prove that this is true and extend verse 11, which is saying that historically this has been the case and says extend the impact. They are using black people as a system of collapsing this black people as a method of collapsing the system, which is inherently anti-black, or they do collapse the system, but all they do is they mean that subject only black people to go on to trial, and that means that they go to trial and he's forced to light them. And so next often what they should ask, you first say aren't racist, but first this is non-unique. This is non-unique in your world either. It doesn't take the fact that racism exists. And the point is not that we the racism will or will not exist. We're saying that we shouldn't subject themselves to the racism when it exists anyways. You say that hundreds of prosecutors enter the system, but we feel that as well. We're just saying that subjecting them is bad. Even if you have less black people going up to trial, it's still not better to allow them to have an option of the plea deal and the fact that they are racist. Next they say that allows for reform, but no, the CP solves the entirety of the CP solves the entirety now, but there's still going to be the next extent of it's a bad next. You say that it's a bad survival strategy, but you're assuming that there are bad consequences for taking a plea deal, but we argue that first bad people have empirically already chosen plea deals as a better survival strategy, but this is much because for them it's a better prospect, because instead you risk having an entire life in prison, because white people don't deliberate when they're making the decisions in court, which means that it's about a survival strategy. It should be important. It's the only thing that is historically stopping them right now from having to subject themselves from a racist jury, regardless of whether or not you uphold the criminal justice system. It doesn't change the fact that Louisiana, North Carolina, and Alabama are going to be largely white and going to strike black jurors, and racism is just going to exist. You shouldn't just force people to go in front of it. So next, go on to the case. So extend all of the circumvention that I make on the case at all. First you say that they wouldn't want to risk their job, but this is empirically proven. The Economist 17 card and the second card say that there are in other places in which they have abolished plea bargaining. It's empirically happened to circumvent the law. There are tons of circumvent the law. There's absolutely no warrant. There are arguments talking about they don't want to risk their job, taking it with their brain and salt. Next you say that they want or they will persist and want to demand, but there's absolutely no internal link between them. But yes, isolated and absolutely no internal link between abolishing plea bargaining and making sure that all the prosecutors will want to demand it. But in fact, all of the warrants within the Economist have known for years. I've got warrants. We're talking about how they consistently want to plea bargain. Just feeling that they abolish the system isn't enough to make them change their minds on that issue. The major impact here is first that the CP is always going to solve comparatively better, because there's absolutely no way we can get around from the fact that plea bargaining exists in the system. We should just make sure that they have a system. And the second, it says that you don't even crash the system in the first place. You need to absolutely know that benefit to doing the act, because they will just allow for the criminal industrial complex to continue surviving and persisting on itself. And next you go on to the sentencing thing. So first you say that you go after big crimes, but we're saying this is a take on your solvency claims, because that means you're still going to have lots of people within prison in the first place. It means that we're going to put lots of people in prison because we're just going to stick them in there for longer, which means that the prisons are always going to be around and you don't have all the root cause of your impact. So the round breaks down super simply. First, it should be a question of whether or not you plea bargaining is essential to breaking down the system. Our higher evidence and your higher evidence indicates that it's not, and legal reform is all that's necessary. Second, it's clear that currently as it stands right now, racism exists in either world, but it should be a question of whether or not you want to force innocent black people to deliberate in front of the trial when they have to. And next, all of their circumvention arcs mean there's absolutely no net benefit to doing the plan. It just gets circumvented. The CP is always going to be net preferable, and because at first it allows for reform, and second, there's no way that they can cause a right trail to restructuring, since it just happens to be that the system will collapse.
Thank you.
way, where's Luis?
Hmm?
Where's Luis?
I have no idea. I thought he went to the bathroom.
Alright, make sure he doesn't come back during the 2 AR. That's going to annoy me if he does that. Alright, sorry. Continue. What's
the
order?
Yeah, so the order, I think it's just going to be like a like AC counter plan. Yeah.
Alright.
And then I'll address the disad when I'm...
Yeah, sounds good.
Increase for us to collapse the system, in which prosecutors are not going to be able to circumvent the system like fast enough to be able to prevent the system. They're going to have to pick and choose which ones they go for. This arbitrary call is going to make them question the criminal justice system and demand that legislators call for reform. Second, as she doesn't respond to the ideas that police practices are also going to be reformed because they're going to realize that the prosecutors are not going to be able to get through all these cases fast enough, which means that they're going to be going after fewer people. He then goes for the Silveri evidence, which says that we're going to increase people, which is that I do not solve. But no, I say this shows that the app does solve 100% because in a world in which we don't have plea bargaining, we don't go for misdemeanor crimes, but we go for felonies only, which means that these are always going to have a longer length in sentences. We have fewer people in jail, but the people who need to be in jail because of like what they have done are just going to be there longer. So fewer people, just a couple people will be there longer, which means the AC still solves. Now let's go into the counterplay. He doesn't particularly respond to the three solvency deficits, which means that the AC is always going to be better. First, I say that this is still going to have this assembly line process. He says there's going to be less people in the system, and the assembly line process is not the sole cause. But you can cross apply the Alvin card that says that the Durbin card that says that plea bargains shields over criminalization, because the reason why we have over criminalization is because prosecutors can go through like 500 cases in 10 minutes and not actually have to think about it or spend a lot of time in trial. If we take out this main tool, this means that they're just not going to have the time, which means we break down the assembly line mentality. The second thing is the time frame. A decriminalization is going to take longer because first these people have to commit the crimes, then the police officers have to find them, and then the like laws have to go into effect within the trial, which means that the app is going to be able to solve immediately because we make prosecutors the next day have to stop prosecuting so many people. Then the third way that the counterplay does not solve is that he only decriminalizes drug offenses. I say that drug offenses are really a small drop in the bucket, and he's not actually solving the true cause of mass incarceration, which is plea bargaining, which means that means that you're going to do perm, do both. He says there's no solvency deficit, there's no net benefit. I say the net benefit that we make prosecutors and police officers realize how messed up and screwed up the criminal justice system. This is the key internal link to having reform in the future. This is going to outweigh the jurors' dissent because he already conceded that this is not unique. Every single part of the criminal justice system is stacked up against black people, prosecutors, the police officers, the laws. Just because they have to go in front of a white jury is not going to increase anymore the fact that the system is already made against them. We are the only one who, you can set the third term, which he drops, which says that we decriminalize offenses, which means that people are not going to be able to be convicted for drug crimes and sent away for 20 years, which means that we prevent black people from having to go to the jurors in the first place. And second, he drops the term that because there's going to be prosecutorial decisions, there's going to be less cases, so less likely. So the three solvency deficits are going to outweigh the impacts of the disadvantage, because the disadvantage is non-unique, and that's why you're always going to do the perm, because it actually is able to solve for the root cause of mass incarceration.
I just feel like people like the RFDs, and if I'm filming the debaters, I should also record the RFDs. Apparently my ballot had errors. Hold on. Alright, there we go. Alright, this is one of the best rounds I have seen probably all year. I think you all were really solid on both sides. I think the analysis was really in-depth. That said, I ended up voting negative, and my reason for it kind of lies in this issue of I'm not exactly sure what, at the end of the day, the AF would have that could be weighed against the counterplan. The counterplan is claiming, as far as I can tell, that it does the reforms that collapsing the system would cause. If that's the case, and he's reading your, Heiner back at you and saying this is what your own authors advocate, then it seems like he's skipping the step of abolishing plea bargaining. And I think then the 2NR is right when he says that you need to show a reason why plea bargaining is uniquely key, why that's something necessary. And so I don't have an answer to that. Now, I can go through the line by line on the indicts. I think he has good answers for why, you know, assembly line process is dealt with by less people in there, and why time frame is dealt with, as well as drug-related crimes or other parts to the counter plan. It's a full reform. But even if that's not the case, as far as I understand it, the CP is what the AFC claims will happen. And I know this isn't explicitly said, but I don't know how else to interpret it, which leads me then to think that it's the turns are non-unique. It leads me to what's the only remaining unique offense, and that would be the disad flow. And so then the question is the disad non-unique, or is it, can that case outweigh? Well, if the counterplan avoids it, then it means that if there's any sort of disad there, it's relevant. Your argument is that it's non-unique, that it's already stacked against black people. I understand the jurors' disad to be saying that it's not about, you know, the system being stacked against them. It's about 5 years in prison versus a whole life in prison. It's a question of, you know, would you rather face an all-white jury that's going to be racist or a bad plea bargain? So while you are right that maybe the whole system's bad, maybe even plea bargains are racist themselves and bad, he's saying that it is a better tactic to pursue than it is to just go to trial and risk the chance of life in prison. I think that the biggest issue then was, I think that there needed to be more. Normally, this would have worked for me. The strategy would have been like beautiful, and I would have been very happy with it. The one thing is that the CP, as far as I can tell, is just fiatting ahead of the AF. But because of that, I think you need to have more line by line on the disad in this circumstance than just the outweighing.
Okay.
Any questions?
Yeah, I have a couple.
Yeah.
Okay, so first, what about the turns on the jurors disad?
So my flow, I mean, I don't have you go to the jurors disad explicitly in the 2AR. Now, maybe that's because I flowed it differently. Maybe that's not. I went through my entire 2AR flow, and the best I have is at the end of the counterplan flow, where you're making arguments about how you say, outweighs the disad, conceded it's a non-unique, CJS is already stacked against black people. I think this is a weighing argument. It's, you know, some years in life, some years versus life. The second argument you have is just because the white jury doesn't, doesn't change, that the system is still going to be against them. A little bit hard to understand. I understand that to mean that, like, the system is still against them, so you don't solve the root cause. I think there's questions about whether that's true, but even if he doesn't, I feel like that would be non-unique to the AF, since he's fiating the reforms you would trigger. And then the third argument is, you say the third turn not going to be convicted for drug, they're not going to be convicted for drug crimes and then sent away for years. I have to be honest, I'm not entirely sure. Like, it seems like this is assuming just under the legalizing marijuana and drug just type aspects of the counterplan this applies. I don't fully understand how it deals with the other reforms that the counterplan articulates. Does that make sense?
Yeah, no, that makes sense. And then I tried to cross-apply the Alkin card and stress about that it's, like, essential for prosecutors and police officers to, like, understand that the system is messed up, and the only way you can solve that is through, like, crashing the system, and then they have, like, the desistance, and that's, like, the net benefit to the AF. Should I set, where do you, like, I said that on the AF and the counterplan, so is there, like, a better way I should state that?
Yeah, I mean, I have that, and I understand it as a solvency for why it would cause the reform to trigger, right? I guess what I'm missing is why. So you say, like, the prosecutors and the police need to, like, argue for the reform. I guess I don't have it articulated in the 2AR as the I don't have it articulated as it changes their mindsets or it shifts how they view the issues. I see it as they say, hey, this is really inefficient for me. And so because they can't go through lots of cases really quickly and not think about it, instead they go and complain and say, we need to fix it so that way I can get through more cases. If it's articulated as, they realize that it's messed up in the sense of that it's racist, and that's clear to me, and that's clearly articulated, then I think there's something you can do there, and maybe that was what you were going for.
Yeah, but I just need to practice.
Yeah, how I have it in the 2AR is just that, oh, it's inefficient, and they'll complain that it's inefficient. So I need an explanation that's very clearly, you need to change their mindsets as well.
Okay.
So I guess then in the 2AR, or the 1AR, 2AR, however, the way you'd want to articulate against a reform counterplan, you'd say there are two net benefits. The first is solvency, and then the second one is you don't address prosecutor mindset. You don't like.
Okay.
Well, you don't. It is kind of the assembly line type argument, but I think it's more contextualized to the mindset of the prosecutors, because I think he's right that the assembly line means if there's less cases to go for, then, you know, you don't have the assembly line anymore, so it doesn't apply. But I think that doesn't necessarily solve, there's going to be a marginal impact to the few cases that still do exist that are on the assembly line or whatever. Does that make sense? Maybe not entirely.
Yeah, I just personally don't think that, like, decreasing the number of, like, crimes would mean that there's no longer, like, an assembly line. Because he doesn't decrease it so much so that a prosecutor can, like, easily go through their case without using, like, without, like, having to use tricks or, like, shortcuts.
I mean, so...
Like, I don't know if I explained that, but that's just...
I get the insight. His comment is that it's just, like, first, the assembly line's not entire thing. The CP has other aspects. And then he says, second, there'd be far less cases to go for and go after, and that we can also solve for the wide-scale reform of the CJS. Like, the way I have it articulated in the 2AR is just kind of like plea bargaining shields over criminalization so that prosecutors can go through lots of cases really quickly and not think about it. Like, I see it as an efficiency mindset of the prosecutors versus the actual literal efficiency of the criminal justice system.
How's that different?
So a prosecutor that wants to be really efficient is going to do everything they can to make things more efficient, et cetera, et cetera. But that they can only do that within the confines of the actual system itself. So the AF says, we clog it so that it's super inefficient, so that a prosecutor literally can't be efficient. To me, as I articulated in this, or understand it in this round, that doesn't actually solve for the prosecutor wanting to be efficient. It just means that they can't be, so they ask for a reform to make it more efficient again.
Okay.
Does that make sense?
Yeah, that makes sense.
Yeah.
Thank you.
I was just going to ask, would you like to see a better response against the assembly line process? Should I better articulate it all?
You need to articulate very clearly how you're... You need to think, what is the net benefit to the AF? What is exclusive? You're functionally picking out of the first part of the action, you know, and just skipping to the reform. You need to think, what is their unique offense that they're going to generate from that? And chances are it's going to be something, I mean, like the prosecutor's reacting. Why is that important? Or it's going to be something about plea bargains being bad. I think you get at that in the end of the 2NR when you say there's no net benefit to why plea bargains are uniquely key. But I think you need to kind of just blow up the issue that, like, this is what their evidence advocates. We don't have to abolish plea bargaining. We can just skip to those reforms. Fiat that they happen, you know? And then there's, you know, you just read a bunch of reasons why crashing the system is bad. And, you know, you had those, I think, in the 1AR, or 1NC. You had reasons as to why, like, I mean, it might have been cut off short, but it was at the very end of the NC, I think. And those are things that could be in the 2NR. Does that make sense,
yeah,
though?
Should I include them, or was it fine?
Well, I mean, like, you know, you need to, the only, you're picking out of that one part of the F functionally, and so you need to generate offense against that part of the F. You use the jurors dissat in the NR in this round, but I'm saying you could also use other types of impacts. Does that make sense? All right.
Okay. Thank you.
John,